more could a teen celebrity ask for than to be given the run of Disneyland for her own private birthday party?
I'm happy that my parents shut down Disneyland for me, so I'm done for a while.
Although there were still 2 months to go before Miley Cyrus turned 16, Disney wanted to reward its biggest star with a birthday bash in October 2008 that would beat the annual holiday crush and fit in with Miley's hectic schedule. As well as sharing the special occasion with 500 fans who paid $250 each, the Hannah Montana star got a rare day off to hang out with her family, as well as good friends like Emily Osment.
I think Miley does an awesome job. I think she because of who she is, a lot of people tend to gang up on her, and it's really not fair, but I think if you ever get to know her, she's one of the sweetest people you'll ever meet. So, I mean, she totally deserves this party. She works so hard.
Surrounded by celebrities like Tyra Banks, Steve Carell, and Cindy Crawford, it was a great moment for Miley to take time out and look back over the 2 short years that transformed her from an ordinary schoolgirl to the world's number one teen queen. Miley Cyrus shot to stardom in March 2006 in the title role of Hannah Montana on the Disney Channel. The unexpected success of the series, along with the soundtrack albums and the accompanying concerts, transformed Miley into an overnight teen pop sensation. Surrounded by a close-knit family and brought up on wholesome Christian values, her career has been steered by a father who has plenty of first-hand experience of the highs and lows of show business.
He always said that Hollywood's a heartbreak ready to happen, so, and I think that's totally true. So I think if you really do surround yourself out of people and that will keep you aware of that is awesome.
We all make mistakes, but life is about living from your heart, being real, doing what you love. You know, when you make a mistake, you adjust and pick yourself up, and it's, you know, it's never too late to do the right thing.
With a loving family and a good mentor by her side, Miley seems well-placed to survive the giddiness of the media circus and the traps of Tinseltown. But is she capable of staying on the straight and narrow as her star continues to rise? Or will she succumb to the pitfalls of so many teen queens before her? Miley was born in Nashville, Tennessee in 1992. To Billy Ray Cyrus and Letitia Tish Finley. She grew up on a 500-acre farm, along with her siblings, half-sister Brandy, half-brother Trace, younger brother Brayson, and younger sister Noah.
And I'm so excited to be here, but I've never seen an episode.
She was originally named Destiny Hope Cyrus because her parents had a premonition that she would achieve great things. Her sunny temperament earned her the nickname Smiley Miley, and the name stuck. Having already fulfilled her parents' prophecy, she officially changed her name to Miley in January 2008. As a child, Miley seemed all set to embark on a career in music. She learned to sing, play the guitar, and write songs, all by the time she was 11.
It's like an easy process. I mean, for me, some people would think it's hard. I mean, it just depends the way you do it.
Living so close to Nashville, the mecca of country music, she found herself surrounded by a roll call of the industry's living legends. The list included her father, Billy Ray, who became a one-hit wonder with the release of the number one selling single, Achy Breaky Heart. His album, Some Gave All, went platinum by selling over 20 million copies worldwide. The single, Achy Breaky Heart, spawned the 1990s craze in line dancing and the resurgence of the mullet hairstyle. Miley's godmother is Dolly Parton, the voluptuous and flamboyant queen of country with a bubbly soprano voice. Beneath Dolly's cleverly crafted blonde bimbo image lies an astute businesswoman and an acclaimed songwriter who's published more than 600 songs over her 40-year career. One of her most famous hits was the number one single, I Will Always Love You, made famous by Whitney Houston. Dolly has also made a name for herself as an actress, starring in films like Steel Magnolias and 9 to 5, for which she wrote and performed the theme song. Despite her Nashville connections, Miley wasn't interested in pursuing a career in country music. She caught the acting bug at the age of 9, when the family moved briefly to Toronto in Canada. She got some early experience as a guest star on her dad's TV series, Doc, and in the Tim Burton film, Big Fish. Although her dad tried to encourage her to stick at her schoolwork and cheerleading and turn out to be a normal kid, she was determined to persevere with the acting. And by the time she was 13, Miley had scored the lead in the Disney TV series Hannah Montana, about the double life of a young country music star.
Miley Stewart is just a normal girl who wants to keep her life, you know, on the down low, and he doesn't want, you know, her life to be different than any other normal teenager. So she decides to get a disguise and be Hannah Montana by night and do concerts and the shows and things like that. And then, you know, by day, just be a normal girl and go to school and chill with her family and friends.
Within months of the show going to air in March 2006, she'd already become as famous as Billy Ray. Following in the footsteps of Disney's hit show Lizzie McGuire, which catapulted Hilary Duff into the spotlight, Hannah Montana became Disney's fastest growing series ever. It premiered with 5.5 million viewers and became the most popular series on basic cable for its age group within its first 7 weeks on air. Six 14-year-olds just couldn't get enough of Miley Cyrus.
I like her singing, and she's really pretty and a really good actress and stuff.
Well, I love the program because it's got a great sense of humor and the characters are all really good, and I feel I can really relate to the storylines. But I love Hannah and Miley because they're fantastic singers and have great personalities.
Although she'd made it look easy, landing the part of Hannah Montana had proved to be a great lesson in persistence for Miley. She was only 12 when she turned up for her first audition for a supporting role. The Disney studio executives were so impressed with her confidence, her musical ability, and her unusual husky singing voice that they asked her to audition for the lead. They believed that Miley had the everyday relatability of Disney teen idol Hilary Duff and the stage presence of Canadian country pop superstar Shania Twain. Big praise indeed, if you consider that Shania Twain's album Come On Over was not only the biggest selling record of all time by a female musician, it was also the best selling album in the history of country music. The Hannah Montana producers were also impressed with Miley's natural comic timing, which reminded them of a young Lucille Ball from the classic TV comedy I Love Lucy. They also got the impression that Miley, having grown up with a father in show business, really understood the world of the lead character Miley Stewart, who leads a double life as a pop star. However, Miley, a self-confessed beanpole at the age of 12, was considered too small and too young to carry the leading role in the series. Disney also had their doubts about her southern drawl. It would take nearly 2 years and a number of callbacks for Miley to finally clinch the role from 1,000 other hopefuls. In the end, Disney decided to let Miley keep her accent for the part.
I love her show. It's so like inspiring and everything. Like, and she's like close to her age, sort of. So, and then I love all her songs and everything like that.
Starring alongside Miley in the hit show and playing her father Robbie and Hannah's manager is her dad Billy Ray. In fact, he was invited to audition for the part before the lead role of Hannah Montana was cast, but he only agreed to do so after his daughter got the part. After Hannah Montana aired, Billy Ray lost his status as the big star in the family. These days, it's his little girl who gets asked for autographs, while he's known simply as Miley's dad. Another of Miley's co-stars is rising tween sensation Emily Osment. Emily plays Lily in the series, and she and Miley have become good friends through the show. They amuse themselves by text messaging each other as they wait around between takes. In a case of life echoing art, Miley has become a real-life Hannah Montana, playing to packed houses at her concerts, hosting glamorous award ceremonies surrounded by celebrities, accepting awards herself, and starring in her own movie. Miley agrees that her life these days is a lot like Hannah's.
Well, I think I'm a lot like both, because being Hannah, when I'm on stage, I kind of see a totally different person come out. And then when I'm in normal life, it's just me hanging out with my family and friends. So I think my life is very much like the Hannah Montana storyline.
Having two personas to choose from can be useful.
I'm like, am I going to be Hannah today or am I Miley today? Because I really don't want to put the wig on. You know, it's like, oh, I'm not really in the mood today. Or some days I'm like, I don't want to get up and don't want to wash my hair. So I'm like, I want to be Hannah. So much easier.
I love Hannah Montana. Ever since I saw her on a show, I wanted to just get up and sing. And yeah.
It's really exciting for me when I get to meet fans, especially in other places, because I can ask them, you know, what they like about the show and what they want to see, and all the different people want kind of different things to see with the characters. And so I like putting that into certain episodes so they can, you know, keep, you know, being into it by seeing what they've been wanting to see.
Just as Hilary Duff used her fame from the Lizzie McGuire franchise to launch a music career, Miley has used her Hannah Montana fame to kickstart her pop persona. The weekly episodes of Hannah Montana showcase Miley's singing abilities. But more importantly, the show's soundtrack albums offered Miley the chance to develop her skills in songwriting and recording. The first album, simply titled Hannah Montana, features Miley singing 8 tracks as her television character, including the theme song to the series Best of Both Worlds. Miley also sings a duet as herself with her father on the record. The album debuted at number 1 on the US Billboard 200, and it was the 8th biggest selling album for 2006. Not bad for a 13-year-old. Miley subsequently signed a 4-album deal with Hollywood Records. Miley kicked off her solo career in June 2007 with the release of Meet Miley Cyrus, a bonus album released with a second Hannah Montana soundtrack.
Like a cool change, because it's kind of like a Meet Miley record. You kind of get to know who I am and get to, you know, hear my thoughts and things like that. So I think that's really cool, getting to see the different things and getting to see, you know, Hannah and getting to see what she's all about, and then also getting to meet the person that's underneath the wig and the makeup and everything.
Following in godmother Dolly's footsteps, Miley co-wrote 8 of the 10 songs on the album.
It's like an easy process. I mean, for me, some people would think it's hard. I mean, it just depends the way you do it. I mean, I'll start out with sometimes a melody on my guitar and then put lyrics to it, or I'll have an idea and have lyrics and then try to work it out. I mean, it just all kind of depends. I think just to have inspiration is the most important part of it.
The album didn't take long to go triple platinum, and the song See You Again was her first single to enter the top 10 on the Billboard Top 100. Her Hannah Montana co-star Jason Earls became an instant fan.
She's cool. Like, there must be some sort of formula to it, because the songs get stuck in your head and like you can't get them out, you know? There's something very addictive about that stuff.
Overnight, it seemed young girls everywhere had found a new idol in Miley Cyrus.
She likes singing, and she's really good at making her friends have lots of fun. And she's just the person that you really, really would love to meet.
She caused a sensation when she turned up at an HMV store in London in March 2007 to sign copies of her DVD, Hannah Montana Behind the Spotlight. She was greeted on Oxford Street by hundreds of young fans hoping to meet her.
But I just love her, and she's the best girl in town, and not town, just in the world.
Never one to play the shrinking violet, Miley lapped up all the adulation.
I do. I definitely have a lot of Scream fans. They're giving me the opportunity to be at my own stinking premiere. It's like, I love them. Bow down.
While she was over in the UK, Miley did a showcase concert, performing songs from her Hannah Montana album. She also took a private tour in an open-top bus, meeting fans along the way. Back in the US, Miley's popularity soared to even greater heights as she recorded another series of Hannah Montana, and her Best of Both Worlds concert tour sold out in record time. Originally scheduled for 54 dates across the US and Canada, the tour was extended to take in 69 cities. There was standing room only to see Miley strut her stuff, both as herself and in character as Hannah Montana. The tour show was directed by Kenny Ortega, who directed the hugely successful films High School Musical 1, 2, and 3. Kenny originally became famous as a choreographer on the film Dirty Dancing and on the music video Material Girl for Madonna, as well as the Michael Jackson Dangerous World Tour and the History World Tour. Having worked with Miley Cyrus, Kenny describes her as a born performer and likens her to one particular famous movie star of old.
Miley, you know, it's like the old expression, born in a trunk. You know, the daughter of Billy Ray, her mom, Tish, is just so wonderful. Great parenting, but, you know, she reminds me of what it might have been like to know Judy Garland at 13, 14 years old. She just has the magic. You know, she's one in a million. She's a remarkably gifted, grounded, super person.
A Hannah Montana 3D concert film was released following the tour. Predictably, it boomed at the box office on its opening release, taking $31 million in its first weekend, and Miley was its biggest fan.
This is like better than Front Row. It's, you know, you get to reach out and you can feel like you can touch my hand and you can see me right then and right there, right in front of you, which is so fun. And then also just to get to see behind the scenes, which I think is like the most clever part of anything is, I mean, just getting to see what all goes into this, because they can walk around, you know, knowing what real hard work it is. Not only, I mean, I think I have the easiest job.
The film gave Miley a unique opportunity to sit in the audience for a change.
I think just getting to go in there and really see what like the hard work was all for, because 6 months my life has been pure tour, so that's the most exciting thing, I think, is to see what I finally work for, because it'll be the first time I'll ever be able to, and probably the only time I'll be able to see myself really right there and feel like I'm at my own show.
But straight after the screening, the busy young star was on the road again.
I am leaving the venue right now to go to my bus, and then I'm driving like a crazy long hours to get to, I'm pretty sure, Salt Lake City, which my sister is meeting me there.
In March 2008, an excited Miley was both guest and performer at the Nickelodeon Kids' Choice Awards in LA. Surrounded by her peers and her fans, she was in her element.
Oh, I think it's just so fun because not only it's a lot like, you know, on Hannah Montana, it's like we're all like a big family. And so coming here, it's like just joining in. I love that. I think that's so cool.
Looking glamorous on the more orange than red carpet, Miley wasn't taking any chances with her designer frock.
I did it. I'm not getting slimed. I know I'm not. I promise you I won't be. But my dress is Stella McCartney, and I just basically picked the sparkliest thing on the rack as usual.
After performing at the 2008 Kids' Choice Awards, she flew back to Tennessee in April to begin shooting Hannah Montana the movie. In the film, Hannah feels overwhelmed by her popularity and returns to her hometown to reflect on her life. Once again, there were plenty of parallels with her own life. Desperately in need of a break from the roller coaster ride of stardom, Miley was relieved to escape LA for a few months to complete filming. She got to ride horses, go to a carnival, and attend regular school, albeit in front of the movie cameras. She also got to catch up with her godmother Dolly, who plays her aunt in the film and who performs in the concert sequence. Reports appeared suggesting that Miley may have taken over from Britney Spears as the new teen queen in the eyes of the paparazzi.
I don't know. I get followed around a lot, but I try to, you know, keep my space and live my life. You got to do that.
In fact, her meteoric rise to stardom had many showbiz reporters expressing fears that she might go the way of Britney Spears, who went from bona fide pop phenomenon to tabloid joke. After throwing her name away with racy magazine shots, even racier videos, and a string of drug and alcohol-related incidents. Then there was the example of fellow Disney child star Lindsay Lohan, who hit the LA party scene and ended up facing arrest charges for drug possession and driving under the influence of alcohol. She admitted to a drug and alcohol dependency in 2007 and has been in and out of rehabilitation facilities. However, Miley tries to distance herself from these fallen teen queens and is confident that she can avoid the same fate.
The decisions have nothing to do with me either, so it's like you just have your own heart and you have your own soul to kind of help you through life.
Thankfully for Miley, she also has her dad to help her through.
To borrow a line from Miley's song, nobody's perfect, you know. I don't point a finger at anyone, and neither does Miley. Nobody's perfect in this world.
And according to Miley's fans, their idol isn't about to go off the rails.
Like, she's not going to turn into one of those bad people like Britney Spears and everybody, and she's, like, a really good role model and stuff. She's really nice.
Taking her role model responsibility to her millions of young fans seriously, Miley believes she has the right attitude to withstand the pressures of life in the public eye.
My number one thing that always keeps my mind is you can't live a positive life with a negative mind.
At the same time, the girl still wants to have fun.
Not only with that and not only with the show, but I mean within interviews and within everything, you can just see all, you can really see all that I am and all that I want to be. So I think that's what, I mean, just not being too conservative where it's like, you know, she doesn't have any spice, so she doesn't have any, like, you know, fun within her. But I think still, you know, you can be cool and you can be crazy and fun and loud and do what you want to do, but also you just got to do it where you're still being responsible.
However, Miley is all too painfully aware that no matter how carefully she conducts herself, the tabloids will never miss an opportunity to dish the dirt, even if none of it is true. For a while there, at least, she managed to keep her image squeaky clean. But it didn't take the gossip columnist long to get stuck in by claiming she had numerous boyfriends.
I just, like, when things like that come out, there's so many different things, like in all the teen magazines and stuff like that, it's like Miley has like 15 boyfriends. You know what I mean? It's like all these different people. So it's just really random, but I'm single. And there's just a lot of crazy things that come around, but I think it's all kind of, it's fun to read.
Then the rumors began circulating on the internet. A fake article on an online teen magazine speculated that Miley was pregnant, and the story spread like wildfire. Miley's representatives came out quickly with a denial, and Miley was confronted about the rumors at her next red carpet appearance.
I think they're trying to put me in the category that I don't belong in, because I'm in the good girl category and I want to stay there.
Miley is determined to style herself on wholesome teen idols, such as Hilary Duff and Beyoncé, the sober, church-going, totally focused showbiz machines who managed to steer clear of tabloid muckraking.
Beyoncé is here. My mom is always telling me, what would Beyoncé do? So I'm excited to be here tonight.
But despite all of her attempts at maintaining that good girl image, she managed to put many parents of her young fans offside in 2008 when photos of her in Vanity Fair magazine taken by Annie Leibovitz appeared to show the young star topless. The Vanity Fair photos of Miley Cyrus showed her with her bare back exposed. Even though her front was covered with a bedsheet, it was all too much for many conservative parents, who were appalled by her apparent nakedness. Miley's parents tried to defuse the situation by confirming that they had supervised the shoot. Annie Leibovitz defended the photos, as did many of her fellow celebrities.
if the question is, you know, but she's 15 years old, should she have done that? It's like, yeah, but most 15-year-olds don't have their own show, aren't like rock stars. I mean, you can't compare it. And really, if she's going to do that, she did it with the most amazing woman, with this Annie Leibovitz. I mean, I kind of think it's all good.
But not all of her peers were so effusive.
I think you have to live with, you know, what you do. And you have to stand up for it or not, you know? I think it's always hard for an outsider to say that's right or that's wrong. I think you have to look in the mirror and you have to like what you've done.
Reporters went as far to claim the photos amounted to well-calculated titillation. Although Miley originally thought the photos were cool and artsy, she was forced to do a backflip when the negative publicity began to threaten the Walt Disney Company's billion-dollar Hannah Montana franchise. Miley quickly issued an apology, saying that she felt embarrassed for what had happened and that she was truly sorry for having disappointed her fans, who she cares so deeply about. Journalists were quick to hit on former Wholesome Teen Queen Hilary Duff for comment. Perhaps they were hoping that she would toe the Disney line and condemn Miley's actions.
I kind of just heard about it. I guess when I was at Regis and Kelly, but yeah, I don't really know how I feel about it. I feel bad if she regrets it. That's never a good feeling to have, you know.
When Miley appeared at the Disney Games in Florida after having been besieged by the press, she was not quite her usual exuberant self.
I really wanted to be here to compete, but I've been in Nashville, Tennessee, which is my hometown, filming my movie Hannah Montana, so I haven't been able to compete. But first, I want to say we're all winners here because we helped support four great charities this week.
It was rumored that Miley used her filming schedule as an excuse not to take part in the games because she felt under too much pressure from the press. Given that Miley is such a huge star for Disney and a fan of the annual games in Florida, her absence from the event appeared to speak volumes. Whatever the truth, it was clear that Miley was grateful for the ongoing support and prayers from her fans.
I think she is getting put under too much pressure. It was just something she did and she regrets it, and she admitted that she regrets it, so I think they should all drop it.
While the paparazzi set about haranguing Miley, her fans stayed loyal. At the 2008 Kids' Choice Awards, Miley got the best of both worlds, receiving honours for favourite female singer and favourite TV actress. Not bad, given that all up there were 88 million votes cast by young viewers to determine the winners. In July, Miley released her next record, Breakout. It was her first truly solo release that drew no connection to her Hannah Montana character. And it finally gave her the chance to express her own style and personality.
I think this is really gonna kind of help the confusion. I think this is gonna kind of really set me apart. Hopefully people after the Breakout record, I feel like it was appropriately titled, because I hope this does kind of break me out as a more of a songwriter more than just a pop singer.
She ended up co-writing 8 of the songs on the record, including the hit single, 7 Things, which peaked at number 9 on the Billboard Singles chart. This time around, however, she admitted that the songwriting had been a hard slog, particularly in the lead up to the album.
It was long, you know, writing them all out. I would be like falling asleep during writing my songs, but I was like, gotta finish. So I guess just staying up late and writing music no matter what, because you're never off the clock when you're doing an album.
Part of the process involved detaching herself from outside influences.
My favorite groups are The Killers and Coldplay, but I definitely wouldn't, I don't really like people to inspire my records. I like to inspire my records, I like my fans to inspire my records, so I never sound like anyone else. I really try not to listen to any other music but what I'm writing, so I don't sort of sound like anyone else.
The album debuted at number 1 on the US Billboard charts, and the song 7 Things became Miley's highest charting single. A mix of pop and Avril Lavigne-style teen rock, the record was aimed at an older audience than her TV series.
Well, as I've gotten older, so have my fans. The people that did start out as, you know, 12, 13, now they're 16 years old, as I was, and, you know, and now the ones that were 16 years old are now 18, and as I want to embrace my older fans, and so I think this is kind of like a breakout record for my older age and that demographic.
In August 2008, Miley prepared to throw herself into the spotlight again to host the Teen Choice Awards in front of a huge LA crowd.
Miley Cyrus, she's going to do a great job presenting today. I really like her because she's so confident. Like, she really just, she knows what she wants. And so she's a good choice, I think.
It was a big build-up, but she didn't disappoint. She kicked off the ceremony with a performance of her single Seven Things, then picked up three Teen Choice Awards for TV Comedy Actress, Female Music Artist, and TV Comedy for Hannah Montana. While it's clear that Miley loves being adored by her fans and laps up the media attention, she's managed to resist the inevitable pressure about her image and what she should or should not look like.
I think sometimes, I think, of course, like, you're surrounded by people, if you see them and say, well, she looks like that or she's wearing that, I feel like everyone feels a little bit of pressure. But then also, I think you also have to be, okay, do I really want that? Who am I really? What's going to show my personality? So everything that I do, I think, kind of shows a little bit of me through that, so I don't, you know, you set your own trend. Other people are going to want to follow what you do, which is the coolest.
And she admits that she does sometimes miss not having a normal life.
I do sometimes, but then again, it's kind of, I mean, it definitely is fun, and it's been really nice because having my uncle as my bodyguard and my mom with me and my dad, you know, working with him, then my family wants the best for me, so they really find a way to make sure I can still go out and hang out with my friends and also have a normal life of my own.
Throughout her rise to superstardom, Miley has managed to remain very close to her family, particularly to Billy Ray, who is both her business manager and her mentor. Her easygoing dad is also the one she chooses to confide in when she needs to talk. Miley's mum, Tish, on the other hand, is more strict, but she's the person that Miley says she most looks up to. Tish encourages Miley to keep a close circle of friends, and if Tish gets a bad vibe about someone in Miley's life, she tends to hang close to keep her daughter safe.
I just think surround yourself with good family and friends, because that's what I've done. Without that, I think I'd be going a little crazy myself, because if you don't have, you know, someone to pull you aside and tell you that they love you and that they see way beyond what other people just see, they see you out in the public eye and don't really get to know you. So I think if you have people that really get to know you and love you for that, then that's what will really keep you grounded.
Miley is close to her siblings too, particularly the younger ones, Noah and Brayson. Having spent days and weeks together in cramped quarters on the road during Billy Ray's tours, the Cyrus kids have learned to get along. And now that it's Miley's turn in the spotlight, the family are happy to cram into their state-of-the-art tour buses and follow her from city to city. Having grown up on a farm in a tight church-going community, Christianity is also a big part of Miley's life. She believes that she is in Hollywood because it's God's will, and that whatever happens in her career, she will have faith to fall back on. She trusts that her parents' traditional values and her family's emphasis on God will help her keep on the straight and narrow. Alongside good mates Emily Osment and Mitchell Musso from Hannah Montana, Miley has struck up friendships with the Disney star couple Vanessa Hudgens and Zac Efron of High School Musical fame. Zac, Vanessa, and Miley cross paths at various Disney events and often competed together in the Disney Games in Florida. Miley also had a brief cameo in High School Musical 2, dancing at the end of the credits in front of the pool. So the trio got to hang out together at the film's premiere. Responding to speculation on the internet that she would like to date Zac, Miley dismissed the idea, confirming that not only was Zac not her type, he is going out with her friend, and you don't date your best friend's boyfriend. Another young star who clearly was Miley's type was Nick Jonas, the youngest of the Jonas Brothers, who opened for Miley on her Best of Both Worlds concert tour. They had just released their self-titled second album and had guest starred in an episode of Hannah Montana. Touring together gave Miley plenty of time to hang out with the boys. The story goes that she immediately fell for the charismatic Nick, who exuded the Jonas Brothers charm that has captivated fans and show business peers alike.
They're really, really nice guys. The Jonases are so sweet. I've read some things online and people are like, oh, they have egos and they're full of themselves. And I'm like, no, no, no. Like, they're so nice.
They walk into a room, you're just like, okay, those are rock stars. They're not to mention, I mean, obviously they're talented and obviously they're good looking, but it's the way that they present themselves, they're gentlemen.
With a lot of time to kill on the tour, traveling from one town to another, Miley and Nick's friendship developed. While Miley was a veteran of touring at the age of 15, it was all new to Nick.
It's funny, you really have to like kind of sit back sometimes and take it all in, you know, whenever you play a show in front of a lot of people and other than you dreamed about playing one time, you have to kind of sit back and be like, man, like this is actually happening. It's really crazy. It's kind of that also thing where at the end of the day you play the big show, you come back into your hotel room and it's just you and nobody else. It's like polar opposites. So it's like a weird feeling. Those are the kind of things you have to get used to on the road.
Romance blossomed for Miley and Nick, who not only shared a mutual love of singing and songwriting, but also a commitment to Christianity. Nick and his brothers come from a much more conservative family than Miley, however, and as evangelists, all three Jonas boys wear purity rings, given to them by their parents to symbolize their commitment to no premarital sex. They also abstain from alcohol, tobacco, and drugs. Miley's parents were no doubt delighted with Miley's choice of first boyfriend. Other celebrity parents agreed.
Well, I think you know, anybody that has strong parents, and obviously those that know these young men and their mom and dad are both terrific people that are really watching out for them and staying with them every step of the way. That's important. It just goes to show that you can have great success and do good stuff and still be somebody that's a role model.
Even with the intense glare of the spotlight trained upon her, Miley managed to keep her two-year relationship with Nick Jonas under wraps until they split in 2007. It may have been the pressure of the media, or the relationship may simply have run its course. Miley told a teen magazine that she bawled her eyes out after the breakup and dyed her hair black to distance herself from the person she'd been with Nick. Rumors abound that Miley's hit single Seven Things is about the breakup. The song chronicles seven things that she hates about her ex and seven things that she likes about him. Miley won't be drawn into confirming this, but says she still loves Nick, although she's no longer in love with him. Nick agrees.
She's a great friend.
Although everything appeared amicable on the surface, there were reports that Miley had engaged in a feud with fellow star Selena Gomez, who started dating Nick soon after the split. The rumors of a feud spread after Miley uploaded a video to the internet movie site YouTube that spoofed a clip that Selena had posted. Miley quickly defused the situation by publicly apologizing in an interview, and Selena confirmed that she had no beef with Miley, and she was not looking to unseat the superstar as the next wholesome teen role model. Mandy Giroux and Miley also became close friends while on tour, and the two are now regular fixtures on YouTube. They frequently post videos that they have shot and edited themselves under the title The Miley and Mandy Show. The videos are mainly filmed at Miley's house, and the two friends tell jokes, answer questions from fans, sing along to songs on the radio, and mug for the camera. There are also clips of Miley and Mandy backstage at the Teen Choice Awards, preparing for the dance-off with Eminem crew. Having conquered television, film, the music industry, and the internet, it comes as no surprise that Miley Cyrus now has her own wax sculpture at Madame Tussauds. She is one of the youngest people ever to be immortalized in wax, and her likeness joins 200 of the world's most popular wax figures, including Beyoncé, Leonardo DiCaprio, Britney Spears, Brad Pitt, and Johnny Depp. The PR manager at Madame Tussauds revealed that they were inundated with requests for a wax figure of Miley.
For the last few months, there's been a deluge of requests. We've had phone calls, we've had emails from fans of this major Disney show, and it all just made sense from there. We were getting so many requests to have a Miley Cyrus figure in the attraction that we listened, and we got to work with the sculptors, and here she is here now, and we're really pleased.
The sculpture, which appears at both the New York and London Wax Museums, was unveiled in 2008 amidst crowds of giddy teenagers and young children and their ever-patient parents.
I saw her. I just got really excited, and I got a little bit nervous too because I thought it was actually her at first because it's really realistic.
When I walked in, I was so excited. I mean, I've seen every episode of hers, and she has so much personality, and it was really cool. I mean, that statue looks so much like her. It's almost a spit image of her, and it's just so exciting.
When I walked in, my chin dropped to the floor, because just to see something like this, it was amazing.
With annual earnings of $3.5 million in 2007, Miley was recently ranked amongst the Forbes top 20 earners under the age of 25. But far from becoming a spoiled brat, she proved at her 16th birthday bash that she still treasures the simple things in life.
I got a dog today, so I couldn't be happier. A little doggy named Sophie. I started crying my eyes off. I was so dorky, but I couldn't help it. I love it.
She was also listed among the artists and entertainers in Time Magazine's 100 Most Influential People in the World in 2008. So what could possibly be next for this teen high achiever?
Hopefully just a lot of things, you know. Hopefully I don't get stuck to the same routine. I want to travel a little bit more, and I'd love to go on another tour. So hopefully, I mean, just keep doing what I'm doing and finding new ways to make it fun.
Miley has already started filming the third series of Hannah Montana, and has announced plans to write a book about her life. Disney Hyperion are set to publish it in 2009. The movie spin-off of Hannah Montana has already finished filming and will also be released in 2009. Like Hilary Duff before her, Miley has established her own cottage industry. And as long as she can preserve her untarnished image, Disney is certain to keep the work flowing. Whether Miley can carve out a career for herself beyond the Disney stable is yet to be seen. But for now, she's making hay while the sun shines.
I think as long as they'll keep me around, I'll keep doing what I'm doing. I love it. They keep you really safe, and they really care about you and love you. So I think as long as I can be with the Disney Channel, I'll stay as long as they'll keep me.